Hello and welcome to the WB Mason Coaching Report on GoHofstra.com. Joined once again by the head coach of the Hofstra Wrestling Program, Dennis Papadatos. Coach, welcome.
Thanks for having me every week. It's always fun.
Always. It's always fun when you're winning.
Yeah, it's easier. Let's say easier.
Two good performances this past Sunday at the MAC Sports Complex. Two EIWA wins over Harvard and Brown. Let's start with Harvard, a 20-17 dual win. Split the match, five weight classes apiece, but bonus points in the first three really was the difference when it came down to it. So just take us through the Harvard match and what your thoughts were.
I mean, that's what we were planning. We knew that the favors, we knew that we were trying to not use Ricky in that match, which I think the dual meet score would have been a little different. Their kid's very good at 65. We feel like we can beat him. He's nationally ranked pretty high, but at the very least, we probably don't give bonus points, you know what I mean? Which, I guess, what's the difference if we're going to do me by three or five? So that's why that was the last match of the night. We were hoping to get, bonus points at 97. At 74, we were expecting them. At 84, we stepped up. That was 84 was a big match for the dual meet, where they thought they can win it. We thought we can win it. And we got a major decision, which I'll be honest, I didn't put major decision. I thought we were going to win. I thought we were going to win that swing match. But once he got the major, I said, we just won this dual meet. Like, I was pretty confident that everything else was going to go according to plan, and it did. But they're a good team. They're a hard-working, hard-focused team. As I said, they're much better than their record showed, right? That was a even dual meet. We wrestled pretty well. Like, it wasn't that we just didn't wrestle. We wrestled pretty well. They're a pretty good team with some studs. So was happy about it. Happy with the guys' performance and staying focused and their effort level, no doubt.
All right. Then the second match of the day, a 29-6 win over Brown. A little easier time in the second match against the Bears. What were your thoughts on that performance?
I was happy with, again, some bonus points. I was really happy with Sage, where he came out and he gave up a quick takedown, and then he got silly and gave up quick, silly back points. And in the past, Sage would have lost that match, you know, even though he was the better kid. But this year, he's shown that he's been able to go on to the next point, put it behind him, and he found a way to win, right? So it was, you know, giving up 4 points in college is hard. He gave up 4 points that probably shouldn't have been there, and he still found a way to, you know, to win that match. So I was really happy about that. Kind of set the precedent of the dual meet. I thought Trey wrestled well. Again, Charles wrestled well again. Zach, Dylan, you know, avenged a loss to that kid last year. So he was happy about that. Hoyle avenged a loss against a kid that he lost to in December. We were happy about that. Vinny had another pretty good kid. We thought we could win that match. We still do. 49. We beat that kid earlier, and he came back and beat us. It was a barn burner before, and it was a barn burner again, but I don't like giving up the last takedown and losing when I feel like we're a better guy. And then Holden and Ricky did what they were supposed to do. We feel like we could have won all 10 matches, but they're a pretty good team. They were, for the most part, seven of the dual matches were kind of pretty evenly contested, and we found a way to win them, you know. So I'd like to try to win all 10. they'll be in our way at the conference tournament, so we may match up with those guys again. So, again, I was happy with the guys' expectation to win and their inspired effort that we've been talking about.
All right, so the two wins bring your overall record to 10-5 on the season, so second 10-win season in your tenure.
Yeah.
And then 6-0 in the EIWA, which is a new program record for wins in the conference, which has to feel good after, you know, some struggles the last couple years.
There's no doubt. Our conference is very good, you know, and the way it worked out, we have 7 EIWA duels. And, you know, the truth be told, you know, the top four teams that are all ranked top 18 in the country, we're not wrestling them. I feel like I would like to wrestle them. I think we can compete with them. We probably have 8 top 25 team issues in our league, which of being one of them. Everyone we agreed upon and put up against, we're winning, and we've lost to some of those recently, right? So it definitely feels good, but it was never the goal. I didn't start this year and look at it and said, oh, we can go undefeated in the IWA. I say that every year. So I'm glad that we're on that route. We got one more to go, but it's never the goal. The national tournament's the goal.
All right, you mentioned one more to go. That's this Saturday at 2 p.m. here at the David S. Mack Sports and Exhibition Complex versus Sacred Heart. A big day, the last dual match of the year, Senior Day, Alumni Day, and also a special promotion with Friends of Long Island Wrestling that you can talk about?
Yeah, Takedown Drugs is a national thing that the Friends of Long Island Wrestling have really put on, and a lot of high school programs have been doing it. We're going to be the first Division I program, I think college program, to ever do it, us and Sacred Heart, that our guys will take a pledge that they're picking wrestling over drugs. You know, it's obviously sent a good message, and we're proud and happy to help the task and the Friends of Long Island to be the first college program to be kind of a trailblazer for younger kids to know, you know, that you have better options out there. So there'll be a tiny little ceremony 10 minutes before the dual meet. We'll honor our alumni at halftime. We'll honor our only senior, Jacob Martin, before the match, who's been out all year with injury, unfortunately. We'll honor him. It should be a pretty packed day. There's a clinic going on earlier than that. There's a little kid tournament going on in the PEB. It's a day for wrestling, so get to Hofstra, you know, and the guys need you. 2:00 is our match, but there's other things going on as well.
And we talk about this every week, but what challenges do Sacred Heart present as you enter this final dual meet?
The challenge they represent is they're in the way, right? They're in the IWA, they're coming here, and they train, and they want to be good, and they have a few guys that are good and that can wrestle, and they believe they can beat us. They beat Bloomsburg, who beat us, you know what I mean? They beat VMI, who beat us. So they're going, look, we beat teams that beat them, so we can beat them. And so they perform, they're going to come in with a good coach that's doing a good job. They have a winning record, first time probably in 15 years for them, I would guess. I don't know off the top of my head, but they're like 7-3 coming in, and they believe they can win. So, I don't blame them. So we got to be prepared. So they're going to absolutely be a challenge because they're not going to back down. So we just got to not worrying about it. As I keep telling the guys, doesn't matter who we're wrestling. I say that every week, right? Doesn't matter who we're wrestling. Our inspired effort, our focus of what we're doing, our belief in the process, our expectation to win. As I said, we've made a much big jump of, I believe I can win because my single is better than yours. And then, I don't think you're very good, so I can believe I can win. And now it's turning into, I believe I can win because I'm me and I'm at Hofstra and this single is good and we train the right way. I believe I can win because I'm here, not because of who they're wrestling. And that's paying dividends because our guys have expectation that they can compete with everyone. Doesn't matter who the guy is. This week just happens to be Sacred Heart.
All right. Coach, good luck on Saturday. It's a big day, like you said, Alumni Day, Senior Day for Jacob Martin, Friends of Long Island Wrestling, Takedown Drugs, a youth tournament, and, you know, a great day of wrestling, the last time to see the Pride at home this season. So come on out, 2 p.m., and before for the other things going on.
Yep.
And you've been watching the WB Mason Coach Report on GoHofstra.com.
See you there.